What's up, guys? Today, me and Charlie are going to be reviewing the new deluxe edition. We're just doing the bonus tracks, the new stuff. The Estate Sale by Tyler, the Creator. It is the deluxe edition of Call Me If You Get Lost, his album from 2 years ago. And he just released 7 new songs. Technically 8 tracks, but one of them is... I think just an interlude, and it's this first one that we're on. So, what are your thoughts, Charlie? And also, tell the story of why you have to use your phone camera.
I'm excited for Tyler the Creator's album because, you know, Tyler the Creator is super, super, super cool. And I like that about him a lot. Now, the story about my camera is my laptop blew up, so I had to get a new one. But they didn't come with a camera, so I had to use my phone. Yeah, there was a big explosion. You know, it was a gas leak. And then my grandpa was over, and he started smoking. And I was like, no! And then...
All right, guys, so we're going to get into the first track. And I think this is an interlude. And it's Everything Must Go, track number 1. Are you ready?
I'm way ready, Jose. You ready to do this, Logan?
Yep. All right.
Everything All right. must go.
3, 2, 1, go.
Yeah. Arenas all around the world.
Oh, whoops.
Took another trophy home. Thank you to every ear that listened, bought a ticket, whatever. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. I love y'all, man, for real.
Call me if you get lost.
Yes, the green seal.
Estate sale.
Everything must go.
18. What more is left for us?
So now this goes into Stuntman featuring Vince Staples. All right.
Vince Staples.
3, 2, 1, go.
Show you how to stunt. Show you how to stunt. Show you how to stunt. Show you niggas how to stunt. Only show you how to stunt.
Oh, this is gonna be cool, I bet.
This is gonna be like, I think.
Oh, this sounds cool.
Don't do no cuff and go when I come. No, you can't be my girl. Get charged.
Oh, I like the cowbell in the background. That's cool.
This song feels like it was just like. May just be funny.
Well, this is the collection of the songs that he said didn't make the full album. But he said he really likes a lot of them, so he decided to drop this. More cowbell, more cowbell.
It's a fucking movie with big goals. I'll show you how to stunt. Show you how to stunt. Show you how to stunt. Show you niggas how to stunt. On the left side, I'll show you how to stunt.
I'm feeling this one.
I got a jelly bean, Kelly Green Rose, and a guts off white like a jalapeno. Leather hot and pearls. Shit make Nelly sing songs. Big pearls on a belt make my belly seem swole.
They wanna join us because they can't beat us. In the motorcade playing follow the leader. Back the fuck up.
Oh, I like that. The melody there.
Show you how to stunt. Yo, in the TY, come on, motherfucking creator. Me and Flacco Jody been getting green by the acres. Your fingers crossed. Call me when you get lost, bitch.
Call me if you get lost. By now we've shown you the way.
What are your thoughts on Stuntman?
It's too silly. It doesn't take itself seriously, in my opinion.
I think it was good.
What's the song called again? They're like, just like,
show me how to stunt, man. Show me how to stunt, man.
The entire way. It's like, keep repeating. The cowbell is just crazy. I think the whole track's supposed to be crazy. Now, what would you rate this track?
This track, I honestly am feeling a solid 4. Because this honestly was like, it's the same feel as, and I know you're gonna want to argue with me on this, but it's the same feel that Barry Bonds gives me. It's just it's a little bit, I like this definitely better than Barry Bonds, though. It was just, it's a very just baller song. It just goes really hard. I don't know exactly how to explain it. There's just certain things in the background, I think, that really pulled it together because, yeah, there's the cowbell and then the some of the synths, like, near the middle of the song. Yeah, and then, like, I feel like it was a really heavy-hitting beat that you could really just get down to. What's your rating?
Strong 2. I gotta say. I didn't like the track.
Really?
It's surprising.
All right, so are you ready to get right, into the next track? I noticed when Stuntman ended, it kind of wanted to flow into this really well.
I'm ready when you are.
3, 2, 1, go.
Pulled up in that 18th letter repeat buggy. Had to switch the hue cause I'm LA boy smuggy, but more likely to get hurt by somebody who love me. My lady, she don't trust me, know I'm a sick puppy, know that women throw themselves at me and men want me. Anything could happen for attention and rent money. I got so much on my plate, that's why I sit funny. So many handouts, so much back mending. So I swear it's hard not shaking that fear off. White boy said I brag too much, the black kid said it's inspiring. Duality is tiring, my girl would kill me if she knew the things I was desiring. Suppressing it, get it out the way, I put the sirens in, yeah.
So this is a really chill one. This is giving me kind of the same, like, in terms of the sound, the same kind of vibe as Wilshire. Very different lyrically, though. Never have I drove a Hellcat or a Maserati. Graduated after album 5, I got syndicated. You want the OT? Sorry, G, that picture faded. Come get with me.
Yeah, I'm a dead poet, tabletop stumping.
That was a Mad Lib sample?
I think it was.
Yeah, I remember he was saying something on Twitter about it, about a Mad Lib sample being used for one of the tracks. So if you recognize that as a Mad Lib sample, it probably was that. So what do you think with that one?
I thought it was a very, I liked a decent 4, I would say. I really liked that. I really liked that sample. It was really, really good. It's just like the melodies, and then when you have the chorus come back in, what a day.
Yeah.
She's like in the park or something like that.
But yeah.
I think it was good. I think it was consistent. Now, what are your opinions on this?
Yeah, I have to agree on this one. I'm giving this a light 4. It just has a very different sound to it than the rest of them. It feels very airy. It feels very, very relaxing and calm, like you're in the park, as the hook kind of was insinuating. And I think it fits that lyrical theme very well, because it really just feels like you're taking a stroll in a nice, peaceful area. It was really nice. It's relaxing. And yeah, I give that a light 4. The sample, you recognized it as Mad Lib. I didn't, because I haven't really gone into Mad Lib past Mad Villainy. But yeah, the beat was very good. What was the sample? Was it the part where it goes, "What a day at the park"?
Yeah, actually, watch Moonwalker's video on it, because first Mad Lib samples it, and then he sampled Mad Lib.
Mm. Yeah, I'll take a look at that video you sent me later then, to look into that sample, because that was really good. I liked it.
Let's get back to the tracks.
Yep. So track number 4 now. It's Wharf Talk featuring ASAP Rocky. I honestly have never heard
ASAP Rocky fans.
I honestly have never heard ASAP Rocky. I've just heard of him. I just know that I've heard good things about him. I know Tyler the Creator loves him. So let's get into it. 3 2 One, go.
Call me if you get lost.
If God was here,
call me if you get lost.
I think I know what he would say. Some shit like, you're so beautiful. And your lips look nice.
Nothing on your face.
I got a new boat you should come with. I got a section for your luggage. Bring some fiction and a nightlife. Like a player.
Oh, I like the synths in the back. That's really nice.
It's actually really good.
It is. I really like this one. This is ASAP Rocky. What are your thoughts on Wharf Talk?
I thought it was pretty good. It was solid. I liked the little beat and the beat. The background beat was really good. And then the synth comes in. And the vocals are pretty good too. It's just like relaxed. It's like what was the last track?
It's like you're chilling on a boat.
Yeah, you're on a boat.
That's the theme of the song, man. Or the theme of the theme of the whole album.
The theme of the album.
That's what it's meant to sound like. It's like you're just like chilling on a boat, traveling the world. Yeah. So what would you rate it?
I would say a light 4. I would say on that one. How about you?
I give this like a very strong 4. Like it's almost a 5. But still just like a really strong 4. It was just really nice. Like you said, it's very relaxing. It's a very calm and mellow beat, and I really like it. And then also lyrically, it's just like it really just hits, and I just like it. The a lot of the writing on his lyrics, and the hook is really just good. The way he flows. That's all I really have to say about it. Very strong 4. So
I'd say that's really good.
Yeah. So
you go. Sorry.
Dude, what were you gonna say? I was just gonna say next track.
Yeah, let's just do next track.
Alright. Now we're on to Dogtooth. Alright.
Biggest track.
3, 2, 1, go.
She could rob my face, I don't want nothing in return. Her body counting who she fuck ain't never my concern. I'm trying to buy my neighbor house.
Some bad words.
She could rob my face, I don't want nothing in return.
Oh my god. Is that a sexual innuendo?
Is the flashing lights a graduation track?
Shit your hand, I don't respect. Don't call me king. I'm not your twin. I'm not your brother. We just met. See, I won't
I like the piano in the back. That's, that really hits.
I'm perfect. Yeah, Kelly Green wagon look better when the gloom out. Canary shine brighter in the dark. I bought the moon out. The plane fly better when it's just me and the pilot. Tuition for the mileage. It's worth it for the silence. There he goes. He cast broads like radio. Shit, your lady knows. This young. She could rob my face, I don't want nothing in return. Because if she get off, then I get off, that's my concern. I'm trying to buy my neighbor house and turn it to a yard. If you don't know my grandma name, then we ain't really dogs. Bitch, that's a lot of motherfucking necklace. 5, 6, 7 is the figure for a set list. Ring, 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 bitch, pick up the phone. I don't care if y'all together, I would tell down at home. Shit, I shit me through Perry and back a Phantom of the Threads. A driver's seat at
a... Is that a Paris reference?
My leg and Virgil, my chaperone, he look out from overhead. Not sure what you overheard, but it's probably what I said. Bitch, I'm out here, the only option. I don't play no motherfucking game. She could rob my face, I don't want nothing in return. And will I ever fall in love again? I can't confirm. I'm trying to buy my neighbor house and turn it to a yard. If you don't know my daughter name, then we ain't really dog.
Wow.
Wow. Dog tooth. What'd you think of it?
I am gonna give this a light 5.
A 5? No way.
It's the kind of the same vibe as Wharf Talk. It's just kind of really relaxed, and I just kind of have the same things to say about it as Wharf Talk, so I'm not really gonna repeat myself there. It's just, other than just, it's relaxing. It's very lyrically cool. I like it. But I think that this one was done a bit better than Wharf Talk, because Wharf Talk, of course, I gave a very, very strong 4, almost 5, and this one was just a slight step above that, and is a light 5 for me. What do you think?
I thought it was good. I'm going to give it a light 4 to a decent 4, I would say, on this one. Or no, a decent 4 to a strong 4. That's what I'm saying. I really liked it because the synths were good.
They were. Like, I really liked the synths. Alright, are you ready are you ready to get into Heaven to Me?
Oh boy, I'm ready for it.
Alright.
Let's do it.
3, 2, 1, go.
I don't like the spicy eats. I need bridges in my beats and Capanna for the seats. The heaven part for me is no one I can wake up when I'm finished with my sleep. Ain't no kids to feed, no stress I bleed. I don't got view to y'all because that's heaven to me. All the lake water getting warmer from the radiant sun. My baby mama and my daughter getting chased by my son. The water gun, that's heaven to me. Yeah, what's heaven to you? That's really having that 40, like, nigga, having good health. What's heaven to you, to y'all, because that's heaven. This was heaven that, like, as a kid. It used to be the cream hat and the green, the cheetah print on the tee, the dark wash on the jean, soccer mom with the Vans, and every color it seems. Dollars out of dollar.
What'd you think?
Razor, you still going?
Bro, you started it way too early.
No.
I thought that was a light 4.
Really?
Yeah. I think the sample was really nice. I'm assuming that's a sample.
Yeah, it's probably a sample.
And it was really cool. I just think that he could have done more with it.
I think it's just bland. I think the loop is just not great. Heaven only know, heaven only know. It's just like that. I think they needed something more, and then I think it would have been something. But I'm giving it a strong three. That strong Mr. Krabs line, Mr. Krabs line saved it for me, man. You know, the greatest entrepreneur in Bikini Bottom history.
All this right. is this next Are you track. Ready for Boyfriend Girlfriend 2020 demo featuring YG? Do you know this,
Who is this YG?
Who is this YG?
Oh, he's actually kind of big.
Yeah, I see that. He's not in the top listings of Spotify. Yeah. 3, 2, 1, go.
Go.
This is YG, definitely. This isn't Tyler. This feels like an Igor track.
It does. It feels like it's first part of the Igor track, I feel like.
Yeah, it feels like it should be on like the first half, like around like I Think and Earthquake.
Oh my god.
A little bit of a switch up. These lyrics are getting too real for me, man. I'm gonna give that one a decent 4. I think that it was... It sort of followed the same sort of suit as, like, Wharf Talk and Dogtooth. It just wasn't quite as... It wasn't on the level of those two for me. Especially lyrically, it was pretty similar to those, because all three of them are basically just him being like, I like you, to this person, and it's kind of the same thematically, and I really liked the sound of this one. It was just, and then when it kind of switched up, it was like really cool. It was groovy. What do you think?
Strong 4. I like this song a lot. I like the beat switch in the middle, and I like the VG vocals. No, I said them wrong. YG.
YG.
YG. YG is the best. He had good lines, I would have to say. Yeah, I'm really pleased with this track.
All right, you ready to finish off the estate sale?
I'm excited. Let's do this.
We got the last track, Sorry Not Sorry. All right, 3, 2, 2 1, go.
1.
Got some like staticky vinyl noise on there. That's cool. That's always a cool touch when they do it well.
Snap, crackle, and pop.
Rice Krispies?
Rice Krispies reference.
We're just advertisers now.
Yeah.
Oh, this is like building up.
Link in the description to buy Tostino's chips in the description. Sorry, we ain't close as we should have been. Sorry to my old friends, stories we could have wrote. If our egos talk over dinner, I don't even drink. Can't guilt trip me, I'm ice cold, rolling rink. Nigga, read the rule, don't assume. Niggas is cool, stay in your pocket, this is cool. Blah, 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 about trauma. You ain't special, everybody got problems, Sorry, I'm not empathetic. Sorry, you think I'm pathetic. Sorry, I don't wanna bro down. Fuck the numbers, fuck a hook. You put me on the stage and I show you the difference. Let me see y'all hit a stage. Let me see y'all write a page. Let me see you make a decision. I made and claim that I don't know about minimum wage or Section 8 water.
I like the building up.
Stretch when niggas ain't getting pressed by niggas. I've been gay. Thinking it's normal because you ain't supposed to make it past 18. No escape to figure 8 sight. Feels like I'm on a boat. Like a diet, I'ma make a way. Yeah, I did. Feel good, work paid. Now we don't celebrate, but niggas claim you ever get when they can't relate. Tomorrow's a feeling great, so they aim, duck, a shot right back. Buck, sorry, not sorry, fuck em. I got two words. Fuck em. Okay, cool. And like that?
We gone. All right, so what did you think of Sorry Not Sorry?
Yeah, I really liked it. I thought it was very solid. I think it could stand. I think he should have done it as just like an EP, just to release as just like extra. I think that could have definitely stood on its own for sure. I don't even think it needs the Call Me If You Get Lost association with it.
Well, have you listened to Call Me If You Get Lost? Like the
No,
album?
I haven't, but I've heard really good things about it.
Yeah, no, if you listen to it like straight through, I think you would see why he made it like the deluxe edition, because it really fits like just with the sound, and except for that one song, I don't remember which one, but it was the one that sounded like an Igor track. It really fits the sound, and it fits thematically. But I think it could have been an EP, but I think it fits better as a deluxe addiction to the album. But
which works, and he didn't do like crappy instrumentals like every other artist does.
Yeah, he did it really well.
Yeah.
So
he has secret bonus tracks.
Yeah, so what's your rating of Sorry Not Sorry?
Oh, the song, I gave it like a strong 4.
Strong 4? Yeah, I give Sorry Not Sorry, I would say Sorry Not Sorry, I think is like a very strong 4 to a light 5. I'm leaning more towards light 5 though, because I really liked it. It was powerful. It felt very strong. It felt raw. It felt like Because a lot of his songs are talking, like, especially like an Igor and stuff. It's talking from sort of a persona, and Wilshire is one of the only is I think by far the track where he's like the most like raw in the sense of being like just up in front. Like he's not like making stuff up. Like he's been real, and this really kind of felt like that too. It was more like built up than Wilshire, because Wilshire was a very just calm. He was just telling this story. This was more built up than that. But it was really good. I loved the part at the end where it built up and it got louder and louder, and then it dropped off into a nice calm ending. All right. So now the album itself. What are your thoughts on that? Just the estate sale, not the full album, because you haven't heard the full album.
I thought it was good. It was really different, chillax. Way different from Igor. Igor's more like, I just broke up, I'm gonna die. And
at the beginning, Igor's like, more like, I love you. And then at the end, it's like, boo.
Igor at the beginning is like, yay. And Igor at the end is just like,
it's evolution of man.
I thought it was good. It was definitely a different tone. It was really happy. Except for the second track, god awful, but everything else was
really
good.
I don't know why I thought it was really good.
Who has a cowbell in a rap
song? I thought it was really good.
Hey guys, this cowbell goes hard. Real.
Oh man. Yeah, so what would you rate the estate sale?
I would rate it 8.8 because I said 8.6 earlier. But that was just to dilute your memory. I'm saying 8.8 out of 10.
But yeah. So now we're getting into decimals, huh? Yeah,
decimals.
I've got to give a pretty similar rating, about an 8.8, 8.9, somewhere in there. I feel like it's not quite, maybe 9. Yeah, you know what? Yeah, I'm just gonna go to 9, honestly, because there are a lot of the tracks here that just blew me away, specifically Wharf Talk and.
They blew you, bro?
Specifically, Wharf Talk and Dogtooth. I just really, really loved. I was just really feeling those. But yeah. So I would give that a solid 9. But yeah, so that's going to be it. As always, thank you for watching. And if you have any albums that you would like us to maybe review, leave them in the comments below. And we'll look at maybe doing those for you guys. And we'll see you in the next one. I'm a very mature person, so I find sexual jokes wildly humorous.
You guys heard of sex before?
Hey guys, I got an adult joke to tell you. It's really funny. Balls.
Have you guys heard of penis?
Guys, as we know, pee is stored in the balls. So, as our scientific studies have suggested, girls do not have balls. So,
they don't pee.
Where does the pee go?